I didn't say I was going to get divorced and marry you. I just said, why don't you come down Bad Street with me if you feel like getting lucky?
I feel real lucky.
Hello, everybody. Thanks very much for being with us. I'm Jim Rohn.
They love me. They just love me for the next 60 minutes,
and Michael Hayes will be our color analyst, as usual, ladies and gentlemen, here in the Universal Wrestling Federation. And we started off this program with a look back 1 week ago.
Wait a minute. Let me set the record straight, okay? Dark Journey wrote me a letter since last week. I read the letter. She said she had promised her mother she would never mess around with a married man, and she's sorry for her actions, and we'll just leave it at that, okay? She was crazy about me. She was just playing hard to get. All these fools out here got her excited.
Can I look at that letter some of these days?
Hey, the letter's none of your business. Do I ask you to read your mail? Let's just get to the matches, okay?
Playing hard to get. She has a strange way of showing her affection to you, I would assume. But be that as it may, ladies and gentlemen, so many exciting things in this hour. Terry Taylor will go against Mad Dog Buzz Sawyer for the television championship. You'll see that here in the Universal Wrestling Federation. You'll also see a tremendous six-man tag team matchup. Ivan and Nikita Koloff, along with Corsita Korchenko, will be in that contest. We'll also hear some comments from Cowboy Bill Watts. I can't wait to hear that. Some comments I don't think anybody will ever forget.
The only thing I can agree with you about what you said last week is if they were going to take him out, they should have took him out. I know from experience, if you're going to take somebody out, take them all the way out, man.
Some more exciting things, ladies and gentlemen, like on June 13th, Friday the 13th, a super card in Houston, Texas, the Sam Houston Coliseum, the Summer Spectacular. Plus on Saturday, June 14th, what a card in the Superdome. It's going to be a tremendous event there. Tickets on sale at all Ticketmaster outlets. We'll keep you updated on that as this hour progresses.
You know, also, this thing with the Sheep Herders and the Fantastics, it's boiling so hot. I mean, the tag team competition in here is the greatest anywhere in the country. That's why I feel so good being one of the Freebirds sitting on top of the mountain looking down.
Well, that situation, you're exactly right. The Fantastics and the Sheep Herders is far, far from over.
No,
and ladies
not
and gentlemen, now we've got a lot more ground to cover, and we'll do that. But right now, let's go to the ring and our first great match.
Ladies and gentlemen, introducing from Dallas, Texas, weighing 230 pounds, Mike Reed.
Kamala, the Ugandan warrior. There is the one-man gang, 440 pounds. And General Skandar Akbar, the leader of Devastation Incorporated, in the ring, as it will be Kamala, the Ugandan warrior, against Mike Reed here on the Universal Wrestling Federation.
I tell you what, Daddy, the look in Mike Reed's eyes just a minute ago looked like a man fixing to walk death row. But you got to give him guts. He's a wrestler. He put his boots on. He's an athlete.
He signed the contract. He knew who was going to wrestle. It was no surprise to him.
That's right.
For all you people's information, you know the general is back. And I have issued a challenge to any team in this rotten world that can stand up to the one-man gang and the Ugandan giant Kamala. Where are you, men? Sign up and they'll gladly fight you.
From General Skandar Akbar, introducing at 409 pounds, Kamala.
And Kamala's not waiting for the bell to sound as Akbar has issued his challenge to any team.
Well, I'll tell you what, we're one of the teams here. We've never backed down from any challenge. And I don't care what dressing room, what walk of life they come from. Look at that move. Good night. Another splash.
Well,
he's got him fired up. Kamala is fired up.
Man,
that might be a record.
I'll tell you, what a phenomenal duo Kamala and the one-man gang will make as Akbar is trying to get Kamala off a helpless Mike Reed. This team has got to be combined weight of well over 800 pounds, the biggest team in pro wrestling today.
900 pounds, yeah. The bigger they are, the harder they fall. And when they fall on you like that, that's how you end up. You're smart enough to get out of the way, you stay out of it.
Ladies and gentlemen, we'll be right back with an update on the Cowboy Bill Watts situation right after this timeout.
He's gone, he's hurt, he's already beat him. Why humiliate him? Why disgust everybody by draping that Russian flag over. There's Doc. That's right, Doc, take it to him. That's why I like Doc. Doc's a man of emotion. He hates Russia. He always has, even when he was in college, he hated. And the doctor is feeding that Russian flag, and that's my sentiments also.
Wait a minute. Wait a minute. Keep your guys back. Keep your guys back. Keep them back.
He's a proud American. He can't stand it any longer.
You're right. I was wrong. You are a great man. And in the past few weeks, I've been very stupid and very foolish, and you're great.
I can't believe it.
Well, it's about time.
About time.
Hold on.
That's the call-off.
The call-off, and they've got washed down.
Oh, Jaco, they've got that chain. Up.
The call-off!
He suckered him in! I can't believe it!
Gilbert has got
the shuttle!
Gilbert hit lost with a shallow, man! He penetrated it!
Boy, you know what, man? That makes me go to sleep better tonight. He had me fooled. I thought he was bellowing at me.
The Russians are taking over on Watts! Gilbert sucked Watts in!
Look, he's biting that head!
The call-off! They're
choking him! He hit him again! What a plan! That's almost as good as any Bad Street plan.
They're whipping the Cowboy with that chain. He's stopping him.
He got out of his position. He should have known not to mess with wrestlers anymore. He's a president.
Look at Gilbert.
He's showing that flag. He never intended.
They put the flag.
And Doc fighting Duggan. There's a fight back here.
But they put the flag over the Cowboy. Look at that.
Look at that.
I can't believe it. That's a killer.
You know, there's got to be some place where any man can go to lick his wounds. And I'm hurting from the top of my head to the bottom of my feet after what happened to me. And what's more is hurting is what's inside of me. So I invited you here to my home because that's what it's really all about. People wonder why I get so upset about being buried by a Russian flag. Well, stop and think. Since World War II ended, there have been 40 countries that have been buried by a Russian flag. That's one a year. And that's what it's all about here today, because they say the United States of America is going to be buried within 10 years. And you know, it all came about because we started playing by the rules and they don't. We let them liberate Berlin and lost Germany. In Korea, we couldn't cross the 38th parallel and their allies played tag and killed our boys. In Vietnam, we couldn't bomb Hanoi and mine the harbor. They had their rules that we had to play by, and they could do it any way they wanted. And in Libya, thank God for President Reagan. At least he's trying to give us back some pride and rebuild our military. But if you really wanted to take Libya to its knees for what they've done in terrorism, you'd have bombed their refineries. They'd have had no more oil. They'd have had no more economy. But we have to play by the rules and warn them we're coming and do everything just so. Well, let me tell you, if we keep playing by the rules, we're not going to have any homes. And Cowboy Bill Watts is not going to play by the rules. And when you have a street fight, there are no rules. And I'm calling all my friends. Dusty Rhodes, Ernie Ladd, Duggan, DiBiase, Doc, Taylor, every one of them, to stand tall and be with me. And Eddie Gilbert, you and that Russian, all those Russians are going to pay.
Well, that certainly recaps the situation, ladies and gentlemen, and a very definitive statement from Cowboy Bill Watts.
I'll tell you what, it showed the whole thing. As far as I'm concerned, he stuck his nose out. He's a president of a company. He has a right to make some jurisdictions and some rules. He went a little bit too far. I was surprised by Eddie Gilbert's actions. He had me fooled. I know he had you fooled, and he had the big dumb cowboy fooled. But I tell you what, I said it before, I'll say it again. If you're going to take them out, they should have done it, because there will be something to pay.
Some paybacks or some heavy dues will be paid, and we'll be back with exciting six-man tag team competition after this from the Universal Wrestling Federation.
Still laughing over what happened to Bill Watts.
if they're going to get any free invitations to dinner.
I'm sorry, but I can't help it. It's so funny. Bill Watts is probably in the nursing home right now. Nursing homes where they put old people, you know, they lay back and they can't get up out of the bed and they got to have nurses come and help them.
I wish he'd shut up.
Their opponents now entering the ring, Jeff Gaylord, Ken Massey, and Kerry Jackson. This match, one fall or 10-minute time limit.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, we're ready for action here. Jim Ross and Michael Hayes with you at ringside, Universal Wrestling Federation. Thank you very much for being with us. The six-man tag team competition. You've heard the lengthy introductions and the oratory by Hot Stuff Eddie Gilbert, who is so elated over his leadership and his master plan that he pulled off to the T.
Well, he pulled it off to a T, and you know, you think about it, he even had his old man pull.
That's a good point. Tommy was there. That's real sickening when you get your father involved and something like that. And as the old country express, he got sold a bill of goods too.
Yeah, well, it's his daddy's fault. He raised him. I think it was just a great master plan. He had me fooled, and it's hard to do that. Ivan Koloff working on Perry Jackson quickly.
Ivan Koloff, the veteran of the Russian trio and the Russian nightmare, as he has been nicknamed.
Now, they're using quick tags. Now, believe me, this is how you keep it going. Keep a fresh man in the ring. Keep him on your side. See, don't let him cross that 50-yard line. Keep pounding on him and keep tagging in and out. Good knee lift.
Ladies and gentlemen, we mentioned that this Russian Korchenko is the biggest Russian in wrestling. It's easy to see that that is a true statement, because the other two Russians that are the most prominent pro wrestling today are in the ring now. Ivan Koloff.
Yeah, and they're kicking butts and taking names. Good knee lift. See, you know, the Russians are constantly working on the wind, trying to knock the wind out of you, because if you're getting beat up and you can't get your wind, you panic. And as anybody knows, any desperate situation when you panic. See, there you go again. Nikita, right to the gut, right to the windpipe. Believe me, I bet he's batting. What a clothesline!
The Russian sickle.
That sickle, that's like a guillotine.
These men will be involved in the big cards on the 13th of June in Houston and the 14th in the Superdome.
Well, I'll tell you what, it's a shame Gaylord didn't get in. He looked like a promising kid. I've heard about him. Well, he got in for a second. There he went.
Gaylord played football at the University of Missouri and also for the San Antonio Gunslingers. That's how they're darn to the good now.
Hey. When you ain't got them pads on, brother, you find out what it's like. And there it is. That's what they did to Bill Watts last week. And that's what's making him see red.
Look at Gilbert adding insult to injury. Ladies and gentlemen, we'll be right back with a special video on the fabulous Freebirds right after this timeout.
Mama lives there. And we may have to be careful what to say, but she's used to it, because she raised you. She put up with you being the bully from Austin, Texas. I know she had more phone calls when you was in school kicking kids' tails and taking names. Well, that's what we got to do again, because Hot Stuff Eddie Gilbert has got these Russians together, and they're coming to our place, our backyard, and they think they're going to run over us.
You know, let me tell my mama something. You know, being a bully has been in me all my life, Russians. And Bill Watts is a bullet too. Many times we lay on the concrete floor, stomping each other's heads in, kicking each other's guts in, because we fight for what we believe in. And now all of a sudden, it is a trend, if you will, to sell weed. It's a trend to go to Russia and worry about they blowing up their own country. Well, hell, over here, it ain't no trend in Texas. The only trend in Texas is Cowboy Bill Watts, Dusty Rhodes, and Dr. Death in Texas.
Go on with it, baby.
Texas Justice is a bunkhouse match.
That's right.
Come as you are.
We should hang them like
wrestlers. You understand? I have been known to drink 27 cases of beer before a bunkhouse match. Just as mean as I remember, I don't mean that much.
The mud
but
the blood
I have,
the beer, it's
that's
close.
It. So the thing is, if you're mad at me out there, that's fine. I hope so, because I'm mad too. In Houston, Texas, Cowboy Bill Watts, Dusty Rhodes, the American Dream, and Dr. Death now bring Houston, Texas justice. He has a new song, Bill, that says, when I die, I may not go to heaven, but it's Texas is as close as I'm going to
get. Let me tell you, if you don't want to see the mud, the blood, and the beer, don't be there. It's going to be ugly. Go mean. We're going to kick tail, take names, and then we're going to stomp that mud hole dry again.
Dusty Rhodes, American Dream, Cowboy Bill Watts, and Dr. Death, we hate Russia!
Welcome back, everybody, and thank you very much for staying with us. In just a few moments, we're going to see the new video on the fabulous Freebirds. No better person to introduce that video than Michael Hayes.
Well, you know, Jim, like I've said before, everybody knows we're working on our new album and trying to finish it up. Wrestling's our main forte. That's what we love. But just like a good clock that can't stop ticking and it can't stop talking, the Freebirds definitely can't stop rocking.
Yeah.
Let's not lose the match because I like the money.
The devil has emerged at Will Rogers Memorial Auditorium. The fabulous Freebirds have hit the ring. I don't believe it. The crowd is aghast. Kevin is thrown to the orchestra pit. Hayes, Jordy, Roberts coming from the parking lot during the commercial break. Nobody can believe it here. Nobody. This is really, really indescribable. The Freebirds out of control like a bolt from the blue.
We told you. We warned you.
That's it. That's it, isn't it? Well, that's what you get for messing with us. You understand, boys? That's what you get for playing with fire.
You get burnt. That's what you get for trying to steal a dog's bone out of his own backyard.
Wait patiently behind me, yes.
I mean, ladies, am I sexy or am I sexy?
A very special look at the fabulous Freebirds, and I will say this. You inflicted a lot of punishment on some big-name athletes.
Hey, we face anybody, like I said, any dressing room, any walk of life. You've seen us just go through the Von Erichs like I go through a spaghetti dinner when I'm starving. We are the baddest. We're the boys from Bad Street, the million-dollar babies, and we are the best. What can you say?
I think you said quite enough.
The girls love me.
Ladies
Dark
and
Journey,
gentlemen,
apologize.
We'll be back with more live wrestling action. Brett Wayne Stallion versus Jack Victory right after this from the UWF.
No, don't come with it.
Congratulate you on your ingenious way of handling these Americans. Cowboy Bill Watts. Very good. It gave us such great pleasure at beating this big cowboy down, putting him in his place, along with this American Three and this, what do you call, Dr. Death.
They're all getting together. They're all coming to Houston, Texas. They're all going to come in, and whatever they want to wear, they're going to come into the ring against, you've already seen it. The greatest force in professional wrestling is coming together to Houston, Texas.
Comrade, all three opponents are alive. Too many Soviet. You like all American in this part of the country. Sticking the red net. That's it.
It's all going to happen in Houston, and I cannot wait to see. You saw how cold his face is. You've already seen how much blood Cowboy Bill Watts can lose. Can't you see what Dusty Rhodes will look like with red over his face, and what Dr. Death will look like, and let's see what they'll look like with the Russian flag over him.
Ladies and gentlemen, from St. Petersburg, Florida, at 225 pounds, Brett Wayne Sawyer!
There she is, the large, unusual lady, Maxine. Some of those adjectives were very descriptive. Some may have been a little...
Some may have been off base when you said lady.
42 pounds, Jack Victory with Lady Maxine. This match, one fall, 10-minute time limit.
Hey, I don't see Dark Journey. She said she was going to be anywhere Lady Maxine was. See, that just proves my point. What she's probably doing right now is waiting at home by the phone, wants me to call her, because she knows she made, you know, she embarrassed herself and messed up on TV. This here, though, will be a great match. Brett Wayne, sorry, good arm drag.
He's lightning quick. I've made that comment. I think that's one of his strong points. He's a phenomenal young athlete, the younger brother of Mad Dog Buzz Sawyer, and their personalities are a little bit different, but their ring style and some of that ability, that Sawyer family ability, really comes to the front.
Well, I think if he had more of the Mad Dog in him, he'd be further along in his career. Good flip over out of it. He's got the leg. Now, you're balanced on one leg. It's hard to keep going. Brought him up. Turn stopper, and boy, I tell you what, I've had one of those, and that'll make it hard to sit down for a day or two.
Yeah. Victory holding his posterior. And Brett Sawyer is going to, I think, to try to prove to Jack Victory and everybody at home that size is really no consequence, because Victory is obviously the larger of the two.
There's a good knee to the gut.
Victory now, and he has really come to the front, I think. Victory is coming into his own, wearing those... But why don't they wear regular tights for those camouflage stuff like the sheep herders? You know, walk on your own. You have to be a...
I don't know, Jim Ross. What do I look like, a dictionary? I've got all the answers or something. Why don't you ask him? Don't ask me. Maybe he thinks he's Rambo. I don't know.
There's Lady Maxine, and there is a smaller lady that is really looking to get her hands on Lady Maxine.
Well, so she said. Just like most broads, they run their mouth, can't back it up. Hey, you know, a lot of people wrote in a lot of letters last week wanting to know what was that fantastic move that my brother Buddy Jack and I used to beat Terry Taylor and Ted DiBiase. That's called the Bad Street Bomb, Daddy, and a lot of people are going to be feeling it.
Well, of course, that decision was reversed when they saw the interference, so...
There was no interference. It's just another...
Look at that. Now, there's some interference right here.
No, you know, I think she kissed him.
No.
I think she had some affections for her.
That would be definitely interference. That's grounds for disqualification. Neither circumstance.
Good body slam. Drove that elbow right to the sternum, and he's got the leg hook. Tommy Gilmer was a little slow getting down there. I don't know if he's got arthritis or what. I think that should have been a three count right then and there. Whoa.
Stay with us, everybody. Coming up in the next segment, we've got a special report from Houston, Texas on the UWF heavyweight title, the $100,000 tournament.
That's right, and don't forget.
That'll be coming up in just a few moments.
Good turnbuckle. Whoa.
Both feet to the face.
Boy, I think he busted his lip there. Well, he caught him in the nose. He stunned him. Victory don't know where he is. Beautiful drop kick. Another drop kick. Well, he went for a third one. Went to the well one too many times. He went to the well. That's where you see that Victory is gaining maturity, obviously, from being with the Sheep Herders, a polished, well-known tag team. Figured he'd go for the third one, and he ducked out of the way.
I think Lady Maxine had a little bit to do with that miscalculated maneuver there.
Well, I didn't see nothing. Did you see anything?
I turned back and looked. I didn't see it on the monitor, but I saw her off the camera angle. It looked to me like she was getting involved as usual. It wouldn't surprise me.
Well, who are you, Party Fife, a part-time cop, or what?
Well, I'm just calling it like it is. Lady Victory. Maxine has no business getting involved in the matches.
Victory's, he's got the head in this match. He's using his...
There's Lady Maxine, and the crowd is
Wait a minute.
Coming to life here.
Uh-oh. You see what I see? She probably wants to come talk to me. I don't think she wants anything to do with that lady Maxine. After the way she beat her up 2 weeks ago.
Maxine just pulled the rope, and out went Brett Wayne Sawyer. And there's Dark Journey.
Referee's holding Jack Victory back.
Lady Maxine didn't stay down the floor very long. That's a little strange. She's 6 feet three or four. You think that she's a little victory. Victory, now that's a big challenge. He's inviting her to come into the ring. And Brett Sawyer's back in the ring. He didn't need an invitation.
Boy,
all the way over the top rope.
See that? Here they go. All right. I know it.
In Houston, Texas. 7,500 fans witnessed the greatest one-night tournament of all time. Hacksaw Jim Duggan, undefeated in his reign as the North American champion, graciously retired the 27 pounds of silver and gold to attack a new challenge, the UWF Championship. The evening began with the retirement ceremony.
Jim retired the North American title undefeated as the North American champion.
There's 27 pounds gold and silver. There's been some great, great North American heavyweight champions, and I just wanted to carry on in the tradition. But once I got this belt, once I got the support from you people, I knew there was more than just gold and silver in this belt. It's something that's inside of you, and something that makes you drive on. And by God, I'm coming after that UWF title after I retire this one with pride.
To know that I accept the custody of this belt for tonight with a great deal of pride, because I'm doing it for each and every one of you, and I want you to know how much we appreciate your support, and that we promise that this is going to be the biggest and the best summer that wrestling has ever had. And if
it's a big enough task to battle Terry Bam Bam Gordy one-on-one, even for a powerhouse like Dr. Death. But with Michael Hayes at ringside, things became even tougher. The entire tournament was packed with excitement. Every match was main event caliber. As it turned out, one of the most pivotal bouts of the night pitted Ted DiBiase against Freebird Terry Gordy. We see Gordy and DiBiase in the turnbuckles. Reverse Irish whips, and 300-pound Terry Gordy squashes Carl Fergie into the turnbuckle pads. DiBiase sets up Terry Gordy for the power slam. He catches him. Now he goes for the figure four, but watch Michael Hayes. Michael Hayes up to the top turnbuckle, and Ted DiBiase fires him off and sets him up for the figure four. But Terry Gordy is getting up slowly from that power slam. DiBiase is hurting Michael Hayes, but he might have left himself a little bit immobile with Terry Gordy in the ring. DiBiase tries to get up, but Hayes has his leg, and Gordy catches DiBiase with a short clothesline right to the throat. This sets up Gordy's patented pile driver. He is very punishing with this, and DiBiase gets his head drilled straight into the mat. DiBiase's neck was hurt from that, which set up Gordy for a crucial victory. The next match featured Hacksaw Duggan against Kamala. Ted DiBiase came to the ring to second Duggan against the big Ugandan, even though he was still feeling the pain of Gordy's pile driver. Before the bout, Akbar made an offer to Teddy, asking him to return to Devastation Incorporated.
You better pay $25,000, and all you people in Houston are out of work. So here's the way it's going to be, Teddy. $25,000, and you come back to the general where you belong.
$50,000.
Of course I'll make it $50,000. You're on, Teddy.
DiBiase was still hurt from Gordy's pile driver, but he stayed at ringside for the entire match. Duggan and Kamala had a classic battle. Duggan was put in a big predicament when Kamala threw him into the ring post. Duggan, even though badly lacerated, fought on. Earlier, it looked as if Ted DiBiase had accepted Skandar Akbar's $50,000 offer, and the fans in Houston thought Duggan was in for big trouble when Akbar told Teddy to load up the glove and go for Duggan. But watch what happened. Finals. Hacksaw Jim Duggan against Terry Bam Bam Gordy. Duggan had been through the ringer against Kamala, but he was fired up for Gordy. The fans were fired up too, as Hacksaw and Bam Bam got set to hook it up. But then, as a total surprise to everyone, the one-man gang showed up.
Inside of me, I would be the new UWF champion right now, because I can be Dead Man, I can be Dead Man, and I know I can be this man.
Hey, gang, if you're looking for me, if you want me, make your move.
Well, this is a move that shouldn't be made, and Hacksaw Duggan is still suffering from a cut on the head that he received in his last match, and as he takes after the one-man gang, this crowd here is in a tremendous uproar as they roar for Hacksaw Duggan. But Duggan is up against a man who is more than 400 pounds.
A lot more than 400 pounds. And Duggan has made a, he may have made a terrible mistake here. He's getting ready to go for the finals for the tournament. And the one-man gang, and they're battling on the concrete, and I don't like it down here. It's a little bit close for me.
Ladies and gentlemen, please clear the aisles and return to your seat. And he is ready to go. All of a sudden, a turmoil here at the Sam Houston Coliseum, winding up a tournament that has gone remarkably rapidly, and 3 hours and 20 minutes of it so far, and Duggan is having trouble again with the cut that he received on his head was clobbered. But
Duggan has lost a lot of blood.
Duggan is up there waiting to fight. He knocked that one-man gang clear across the ring and out underneath that bottom rope. A solid path for him to travel, and we've got a two-fisted one-man gang gets clobbered again.
Duggan was badly injured by the ring post when the one-man gang attacked. Watch in slow motion as Duggan's head hits a bolt in the post. Duggan lost a lot of blood. Even so, he wanted to have the match. Duggan had fought hard to make it to the finals, and he didn't want to lose his opportunity at the championship. With those thoughts in mind, Grizzly Smith, Paul Bosch, and I all agreed to give Duggan 5 minutes of injury timeout to continue the bout. Gordy and Hayes were livid. They wanted a forfeit.
We're going to give him 5 minutes. 5 minutes. That's all we want. 5 minutes. He gets 5 minutes.
Duggan returned to the ring and fought Gordy tooth and nail. But Michael Hayes was at ringside, and the stipulations were no disqualification, one fall to a finish.
Side of the ring, he has come in now, and what a climax to a sensational tournament. And here is Duggan. Duggan is ready. He is set to go. And Duggan through the rope, not over the rope, through the rope, but there are no disqualifications here. And the referee trying to keep Gordy away. And here is Michael Hayes.
That's sickening.
Giving his one chance.
Oh! Oh! He's been on the floor. Hayes has posted him. He has been battered from the one-man gang and now the pile driver. And it's over. And we got the new Universal Wrestling Federation champion is Terry Gordy.
After the match, the Freebirds had a celebration and made a few comments.
Hey, nobody stops us.
That's right.
We can rock and roll, we can wrestle, and we do look good.
Well, Manny,
I want to ask you something. What is bigger than the world? Tell me what's bigger than the world. The
universe.
That's right, brother. As you're looking at it, you're looking at the Universal Wrestling Federation champion right here, man, and it's a day. It's a day.
In the other dressing room, things were not as jubilant. You can see why Duggan suffered such a loss of blood as we look at the deep gash on the left-hand side of your screen. There probably isn't another athlete in the world that would have gone on under those circumstances. Hacksaw Duggan made a gallant effort. We'll take a look at the new UWF champion next week, and we'll be back with Terry Taylor against Buzz Sawyer for the UWF television title right after these messages.
Television title. First of all, the champion, the current UWF television champion from St. Petersburg, Florida, at 260 pounds, Mad Dog Buzz Sawyer. To second the match, Rick Steiner.
Chavo Guerrero doing out there?
The second of the match, Chavo Guerrero! This match, one smaller television time remaining, and it is for the UWF television title.
Chavo's, Michael, going to be doing the same thing that Rick Steiner's doing.
No, he's not. What Chavo needs to do is take himself back to his little taco burrito stand, wherever, down the corner in Houston or somewhere, and just keep selling Mexican food, because messing with Buzz Sawyer, he's going to get his head bit off.
Well, I'll tell you one thing. I've never seen a fight, and I mean a fight like Guerrero and Mad Dog had in Houston. What a battle that was. And Terry Taylor and Buzz Sawyer, ladies and gentlemen.
Right away, Terry Taylor used a fist. Yes or no? Thank you, sir.
Yeah, he laid it on him. You don't think Buzz won't do that, Michael, if he gets the opportunity?
Well, he should. Took him back. He held on. Good move by Taylor.
Sawyer pulling the tights now. Taylor, the pretty predictable.
I don't know. I don't see no tights. It looked like he just hooked his obliques there and pulled them on over.
He had those nylon tights. Look at this match right here. This is one of the classic battles, two of the supreme athletes in professional wrestling today. Mad Dog Buzz Sawyer. He's been a television champion for quite some time here, but he won it in real controversial fashion.
Good shoulder tackle.
He has kept it like a man, I'll tell you that.
Good lead round by Sawyer. Drop down, Taylor. Flying body press. Could be it. One, two, No, not enough. He didn't have enough wind on him. Right back to the headlock, hip lock takeover, there they are. Good move by Terry Taylor. Of course, he couldn't do that to Buddy or Terry.
Tremendous confrontation. Don't forget the big Friday the 13th Summer Spectacular in the Sam Houston Coliseum and the big one in the Superdome in New Orleans, Saturday, June 14th. Don't you miss either of those big events. And our next television taping, by the way, is Sunday, June the 8th, right here in Tulsa at the Convention Center. Hope you can be with us, ladies and gentlemen. Nothing like it.
Forearm to it. There he goes. Good forearm. Working for that win. There's a forearm across the chest.
And he nails those forearms.
Boom, listen to that pop. Skin to skin. There's no shoulder pads. That's just man versus man. Good reversal. Turnbuckle. What a backdrop.
High elevation.
Boy, that'll knock your sacroiliac out. Good drop kick through the rope.
All the way out. Bass Sawyer will drop kick right to the face from Terry Taylor. And Taylor has the eye of the tiger.
Boy, he does. And I'll tell you what, Sawyer better get in there because referee Tommy Gilbert's counting. And I would hate to lose a world title like that, a prestigious title on a cat. Uh-oh. I think he's just lit a fire in Sawyer. You see that face? It's a main event any worse in the world.
Well, Sawyer now back in the ring with Terry Taylor. This match for the UWF Television Championship, ladies and gentlemen. Next week, we'll have the winner of the trivia contest, too, by the way.
Yeah, next week, also, I decided to let Bam Bam come here. I told everybody, all the wrestlers, I'd give him enough weeks, enough notice. Now he's going to be here. Good shoulder smash. He dropped down. He went for the flying body press. See that? He had got it earlier in the match, and Sawyer was thinking. He knew, he remembered before when he dropped down and Taylor came across, he went for the body press and Sawyer ducked it. That is smart wrestling, Jim Ross.
Terry Taylor now.
Now he's outside. See how quick it switches.
It sure does. There's Rickston.
There's Chavo Guerrero, the little taco vendor. And he's putting them boots to him. Sawyer smells blood. He smells victory. Big high vertical suplex. Boom, and he dropped him. See how he snapped it.
We don't have a lot of time, ladies and gentlemen. Inside 2 minutes here.
I don't think it's going to take much time. He's going to the top. This is it. He smells it. The Mad Dog is ready to bite.
Oh! Taylor moved out of the way, and Sawyer's head was... He rammed the head right into the canvas.
I mean, right in there. Boom! That's an illegal blow. There's the slam. He better take advantage of it and go for a cover. What a... See that dumb Taylor? He can't walk and chew bubblegum.
Steiner tripped him.
He did not.
Oh, come on,
Sawyer. Take advantage. Show him where the Mad Dog's at. He's got him covered. Look. One, two. Come on. Oh, he had a pin before he got it.
And Guerrero and Steiner are getting it on outside. Chavo Guerrero and Rick Steiner outside. And Sawyer's trying to take back over on Taylor.
He missed the knee. Boy, we're about out of time, Jim. I'll tell you what. If you're not here live, you are missing one. He's went for the vertical suplex.
We don't have time, ladies and gentlemen.
Here,
see?
On a
hold. We got a new champion. And we're out of time. We got a new champion.
That was a quick count, Jim.